Hey team, today we're going to go over some basic framing. This is where we use our limbs to actually keep our partner uncomfortable and keep us comfortable from any position. So first of all, I want to explain a little bit about where you want to be when you're starting to grapple. So this is really a fundamental session for beginners, understanding maybe what their first objective would be when they start to train. So if my partner goes down onto the ground, in general, my job is to try to get past my partner's legs and end up between my partner's hips and their armpits, right? This would be a first objective for somebody trying to control somebody on the ground. So if I get in between my partner's hips and their armpits and I can control their shoulder and their body, then I'm in a nice secure position. The same principle would apply to mount position as well. I'm between my partner's armpits and their hips, so I've passed their legs, and the same would apply taking my partner's back. Once again, I'm in between my partner's hips and their armpits to control my partner. So that's a good first objective when you start rolling, is to try to think about passing your partner's legs, getting between the hips and the armpits, and controlling your partner's shoulders on the ground. So if you sit up again. So framing is pretty much using your limbs to be able to control somebody to stop them from getting past, right? So people often talk about long frames and short frames, and basically all they are, I just remembered I got my socks on. Basically all they are is using your limbs to keep somebody away. So for example, if Dawn stands up, this would be an example of using a long frame to keep my partner away. As she manages to pass, I then bring in my knee, and I use a shorter frame to stop them getting in between my armpit and my hip again. Then if they manage to pass my knee, then I start to use either my long frame here, and if they manage to pass this, then I start using my shorter frames. So a key element is to actually know where to hold your frames. If you're using a long frame, and there's a slight bend in your arm, it's going to be very easy for your partner to be able to crush you down. So every time you use something straight, you need to make sure it's 100% straight to be able to have the force here to not let your partner crush your arms down, because as soon as there's a chink in your armor, your arms are going to get crushed. So at that point, I can switch into a shorter frame. So the shorter frame is based on actually the bone in your arm, the humerus bone in your arm, right? This one is connected to your shoulder, and your shoulder is connected to the ground. So there's no way that my partner can actually make this frame shorter. However, if I moved further down the lever, down to my wrist and my hand, then as soon as my partner puts pressure on me, then they squish my frame. So I'll get Dawn to go on the bottom, and we'll show you how this works. So if Dawn has her arm in the wrong place, here and here, and I start putting pressure on my partner, you can see that now, not only have I pinned her, I've also trapped her arms. So try to move your arms out of there now. Her arms are pretty trapped. I'm reasonably comfortable, she's very uncomfortable. So if she makes a slight adjustment and frames towards the elbow side of her forearm, where her arm connects to her humerus bone, and the same here in the hip, then I can put all my weight on my partner, and this makes me uncomfortable and it keeps her comfortable. And you can see I can't shorten the frame anymore, because I can't make that bone any smaller. So, and the same principle applies with the leg. When my partner has their knee inside, of course the leg is a bit more leeway because it's such a powerful load of muscles, right? And nice big strong bones. So this can be a little bit different. Same with the feet. These can be slightly bent because you've got such strong muscles in your legs that you can actually afford to have these a little bit bent. But the same principle applies. Long frame, short frame, long frame, short frame. Okay, so now we're going to go over just some basics of the framing as I manage to pass my partner's legs and I come into the side control position. So the ultimate frame that my partner would do if as I come in would be to have one arm and one frame blocking the arm trying to get underneath my partner's head, and the other frame into my neck, right? So this is what I'm trying to achieve. So my partner's trying to stop me from doing that. So one there and one there. So the one thing I like to do is I like to make sure that my hands are a little bit floppy. Because if your hands are floppy, you know you're going to be relaxed enough to be able to move with your partner. So if I move up or down, across or back, or I move my arm, then my partner can move with me, right? It's like a Wing Chun sticky hands. If you're really rigid and I manage to bump my partner's arm or shoot my arm off somewhere, then I'm going to be able to pass my partner's frames, right? So you need to stay relatively nice and relaxed. So this would be the ultimate frame. And obviously, the next mission for her would be to use these frames to shrimp out and then bring a knee back inside. Now you've brought an even stronger frame into play, and then you can start looking to recover guard. Okay, so let's say, for example, I've managed to get past this frame and I've got my arm underneath my partner's head. The next framing position for my partner will be to have her arm in my hip. This stops me from getting my knee really close to my partner's head. So the whole purpose of this is to actually make the person on top, me, uncomfortable, and the person on the bottom, Dawn, comfortable, right? So you can tell whenever my partner does this, my voice changes because she's got lots of pressure on my throat and I'm not able to crush my partner down. So it's very hard for me to create shoulder pressure, to create chest pressure into my partner. So the next thing is my partner would like to get this arm back, right? Back into our ultimate position, number one, we'll call that. So from here, Dawn's gonna bring her feet next to her bum. She's gonna bridge to the corner. As she comes back down, she's gonna drop her bum, but leave her frame where it is so that I'm even higher. And this leaves a little gap inside the arm where my partner can bring the arm out and then come round and trap the arm, right? I want you to put that hand on my shoulder there. All right, come back a bit. Okay, so what this does is stops me from having my arm around the head, and it also really stops me from attacking anything. So what I want to do from here, the first thing I need to do is try to get this arm back. So Dawn temporarily will hold on to my shoulder to make sure I can't get my arm out. And then when I rip the arm out, she'll go straight back into position number one. Okay, so she's just got back into her perfect framing position to stop me having the arm around the head. So eventually this will get frustrating for me on top. And so what a lot of people do, just let me do this, what a lot of people will do, well, they'll bring their arm over the head and they'll start to control the head and the hip this way. And they'll start to look to maybe isolate an arm. So Dawn's got me here in position number one. Okay. And as I bring this across, she's gonna make an X with her hand. All right, so if I come around this way, Dawn's made an X with her hand. All right, so I come back to position number one again. Right, as I bring this across, try to get to my position, Dawn makes an X with her hand, and she's going to, as she does this, she's gonna use this frame to push my body towards her hip. So now she's shifted my weight. So once again, if Dawn's frame's in the wrong position, further towards the hands, put the other one near the hand as well, that's the one, I'll be able to slide back up and crush my partner's hands. If her frames are in the correct position, then I shouldn't be able to move. In fact, when I move, Dawn just can slide her, slide your bum back, right? That's it, as I move. So that's position number two. So you can go back from position number two to position number one and just have a practice of this. So you make the X, that's it. Make the X, make the X, make the X. Good. And if I ever manage to get this arm around the head again, frame into the hip, frame into the neck, feet near the bum, bridge, bring the arm through, control. When I pull the arm out, back to position number one, bring the arm over, back to position number two. Okay, so the next frame we're going to do is a long frame. So Dawn's going to use the hand that's further away from my armpit to come out of the hip and start pushing on the armpit. So this is really important now that Dawn has creates a long frame and keeps her arm perfectly straight. So once again, if Dawn bends your arm, I'll be able to push back. If her arm's 100% straight and rigid, now I can't push back. All right, so she's got her thumb in there. She's even reinforced it with the other hand, which is absolutely fine. Right, so she's got two very strong, straight frames. Now she uses this frame to be able to shrimp. Might take one shrimp, might take two shrimps, and then comes and sits back up into butterfly position, open guard, whatever you want to do once you're out of that position. So that's a basic understanding of framing with the arms. I'll probably do another video with framing of the legs as well and how we use the legs to make space and frame as well. But if you look at that principle, you can apply that to all sorts of different positions, half guard, side control, all over the show. So if you like our videos, please don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll put links at the end of this video to some of our other playlists. There's heaps of stuff online, so check them out. And we'll see you in the next video.